Hello everybody, welcome to another video from English House. This is Sabik here. Well, in today's video, we're going to be looking at the differences between two auxiliary verbs, may and might. So may is usually used to seek permissions. To give you an example on this, let's say, may I borrow your pen or may I leave now? So if you observed in here, you can also use can I borrow your pen or can I leave now? However, when you use the word can, that sounds more of like a capability. And that doesn't sound like you're taking a permission. So when you replace the word can with may, that sounds more polite. So keep it in your mind, guys. May is usually used in the beginning of a sentence to seek permission. May can also be used to talk about something that you're not really sure of, but the chances of it happening is really high. To give you an example on this, let's say it may rain today, or he may come to stay with us. And by the way, the verb that comes after may is always in its present form. So keep it in your mind, guys. May can also be used to talk about possibilities. Now, let's look at the applications of might. Might is usually used to refer to a small possibility. We use might in between a sentence to show that the chances of happening is really less. To give you an example on this, let's say, he might be at the office now, or I might not go to the office today. And just to give you a quick heads up, may and might are often interchangeable. However, it's better to use might if you specifically want to mention that the chances of happening is really less. Now, let's see how to use might in the past tense. Might can also be used to refer to a past possibility. To give you an example on this, let's say, he might have returned late after the party last night. So keep it in your mind, guys. Might can also be used to refer to something that you're not really sure of, which happened in the past. So these are the different applications of may and might. I hope this video was useful for you guys in some way. If so, maybe you can show us your support by leaving a thumbs up. And if at all you would like to know more about our course, feel free to reach out to us. You can click on the link below. So thank you for watching the video, guys. Have a great time ahead.
English House. English at your fingertips.